You are entering the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music, a collection of vintage recordings curated by your host, Thom Holmes.
This episode, Crosscurrents in Early Electronic Music of Canada, Part 2. Welcome to the Archive of Electronic Music. I'm Thom Holmes. This episode continues my Crosscurrents series, an exploration of early electronic music studios around the world with representative works. This podcast is the second of two parts on tape music from Canada. Here, we cover the period from 1974 to 1992, with electronic works composed by women and men. You can check out my previous episode for more on the story of electronic music in Canada, with many examples from the pioneering physicist and composer Hugh Lacaine, who single-handedly populated the studios in Toronto and Montreal with his own sound-manipulating inventions. Whereas part one largely dealt with institutional and university-based electronic music, this part deals to a large extent, with extensions of that world, occupied by artists who also worked independently. Computers and synthesizers are also introduced as a music developed outside of the traditional institutions. Some composers, such as Norma Beecroft, were welcomed to work in the studio of the University of Toronto. Others, like the Canadian Electronic Ensemble, had some roots in the university system but were wholly on their own as practicing musicians in electronic music. We will also hear additional works from the Vancouver area, where several of these artists, including Hildegard Vesterkamp and Southam and Barry Truax, had come together originally to work with R. Murray Schafer's World Soundscape project. There are glimpses of future computer music in the compositions of David Keane and Bruno D'Agazio, and works more in the tradition of the tape studio, as well as pieces that combined live instrumentalists with tape. All told, this is a lengthy episode, the average length of the 14 works being about 9 minutes long. I present it in chronological order so that you can follow the evolution of electronic sounds in Canada. In the background right now, you've been listening to Lumina by David Keane from 1988, a work for tenor with digital manipulation and sampling of the sound. Please see the podcast website for the playlist for this episode and start times for each of the works. Okay, let's give a listen to this episode of the podcast called Crosscurrents in Early Electronic Music of Canada, Part 2. This is Thom Holmes, and you are listening to the Archive of Electronic Music.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Crosscurrents and Early Electronic Music of Canada, Part 2, on the Archive of Electronic Music. This is Thom Holmes.
Of the sea. In front. You're afraid. You're afraid. In the mirror. Of the sea. In front. You're afraid. In the You're afraid in the mirror for a common pole. You're afraid in the mirror for stain. You're afraid in the mirror searching. You're afraid for a common pole. You're afraid.
Thank you.
afraid to sustain, to carry on through in front of searching. For a common pulse to sustain, to carry on. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
hope you enjoyed Crosscurrents and Early Electronic Music of Canada, Part 2 on the Archive of Electronic Music. This is Thom Holmes. Details about all the music can be found in the playlist on the podcast website. Please check out my blog for the Bob Moog Foundation. There is a link on my podcast website. A transcript of notes for the program are found on my blog, Noise and Notations, located at thomholmes.com. My book about the history of electronic music is called Electronic and Experimental Music and is published by Routledge. There is a link for obtaining the book on my podcast website. You may also want to read my book about sound art, also available from Routledge. If you enjoyed this podcast, I invite you to explore our library of past episodes. They span many genres, technologies, and artists associated with electronic music, from symphonic rock to jazz, all inspired by vintage recordings from my archive. So long for now from the Archive of Electronic Music, and happy listening.
All of the music heard on this podcast, unless otherwise indicated, is brought to you from the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music, a curated collection of vintage recordings. For a complete playlist, go to theholmesarchive.podbean.com. All crackles, surface noise, and other imperfections heard in this podcast are purely intentional. All intro, outro, and other incidental music is by Thom Holmes, unless otherwise noted in the playlist. For notes about this episode, please see the blog Noise and Notations at thomholmes.com. So long from the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music.